Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be designing on the microorganism algae using Photoshop. To design this, we'll first create the inner sphere using ellipse tool and layer style option. Then we'll add bubble particles, organic pattern and inner glow inside the pattern. We'll also create particles cloud on the background. So let's begin the tutorial. Open a new Photoshop document. Draw out a circle using the ellipse tool. Make it small. Now go to the stroke and remove the stroke color. Fill it up with green color from the color swatches. Now select the background layer and apply black color using the shortcut Command or Control Backspace. Next, select the circle and reduce the fill color to 0%. Now double click on the layer to open layer style panel. First, add inner glow. Change the color to light green, size to 27 pixels and the opacity around 49%. Next, add a pattern overlay. We'll choose this organic pattern and change the blend mode to overlay. To see the pattern, let's increase the fill value of the layer. Set the value to around 9%. Now again, under layer style panel, let's scale down the size to 43%. Next, add auto glow. Choose yellowish green color from the color picker and increase the size to 29 pixels. This will add a nice auto glow to the sphere, make it look like an energy ball. Next, add gradient overlay. Change the style to radial and blend mode to overlay. This will add a dark color to the core of the sphere. We can adjust the range of darkness using the scale and opacity slider. Then click OK. We'll slightly increase the fill value to 17% to see the inner texture. Further, we'll do some adjustment with the inner glow and outer glow to achieve desired look. Next, we'll create a duplicate of the sphere. Click and drag with the Alt pressed. For this, we'll change the pattern. So open the layer style panel and choose a different pattern from the list of library. Scale up the size and do some slight changes with all the other layer style. Now we'll create few more duplicates of the two sphere. Arrange them in a circular shape. Let the edge overlaps each other. Next, we'll create the bigger sphere for the smaller microparticles. So create a duplicate of one of the sphere and scale up the size using the transform option with a shortcut Command or Control T. Select the gradient overlay and delete it. Now bring the bigger sphere over the smaller sphere. For this sphere, we don't need inner and outer glow, so uncheck it. Now under layer style panel, scale up the size of the pattern overlay and reduce this layer fill value to 13%. Now, drag down this layer on the bottom of all the sphere and slightly increase the opacity to 22%. Next, we'll add bubble particles to the sphere. So open a new document with a dimension 500 by 500. Here first choose circular brush and add a new layer. Change foreground color to black and start drawing black dots randomly over the white artboard. Give variation in the size of the brush using open and close square bracket. Now hide the background layer and make a selection using the square selection tool. Then go to edit, define brush preset, give the name and click OK. Now if you go to our main file and choose brush, you'll find the new brush on the brush preset. Select it and let's add the particles. Add a new blank layer, change the fill color to white and start applying the brush. But before that, let's bring the blank layer on top and start drawing the particles with small brush size. Open the brush attributes, rotate the angle while applying the dots. This will add random particles to the design. For the corner particles, make brush size smaller. This way, fill up the whole sphere with white dots. Next, we'll mask out the extra particles which are outside of the spherical region. So with the Command or Control pressed, click on the thumbnail of the bigger ellipse. This will create a selection of the area. Now select our particle layer and apply mask. Next, we'll add a bubble effect to the layer. So open layer style panel and apply inner shadow. Choose dark green color for the blend mode. Change the angle of rotation, increase the size and add a slight distance of 2 pixels. Add inner glow. Apply light green color. Make the source to center with a size 5 pixels. And lastly, add drop shadow. Adjust the opacity, angle of rotation, distance and size to get a perfect shadow. Then click OK. Next, select all the small spherical layer and group it up. Now select the bubble particle layer and convert it into smart object. And change the layer mode to color dodge. This will add a nice effect to the particles. Next, double click on the smart object. Here, create a duplicate of the particle layer and rotate it to an angle. Then save it. This will increase the number of particles in our main file. Again, go to smart object and we'll mask out the central region of the top layer. Use soft brush tool with a black color selected and apply it to the center. Then save it. This way, we got more particles on the edges as compared to the center. Next, we'll add a depth of field to the particle layer. So, go to Filter, Blur Gallery, Irish Blur. Set the center point to the center and adjust the size as per the spherical shape. Adjust the blur value to get a nice depth of field along the edge. Move the smaller circular icon to adjust the range. Once done, click OK. Next, scale down the size of the particle sphere, selecting both the pattern and the particle layer. Next, click on the thumbnail of ellipse tool to make a selection. We'll use this to add inner glow. So add a new layer and apply black color. Now reduce the fill color to 0% and add inner glow on the layer style panel. Apply light yellowish green color, size to 21 pixel and the opacity to around 46%. Now adjust the attributes of each of the elements before finalizing the organic design. Also add Irish blur on the background pattern layer and adjust the blur value. Select all the layers and scale down the size, using the shortcut Command or Control T to transform. Next, create a duplicate of the organic shape. Group it up by using the shortcut Command or Control G. Then rotate it to an angle to make it asymmetrical. Create few more duplicates with a variation in size. For the smaller spheres, open the group and delete few of the inner spheres. Then arrange them properly. Next, we'll add background particles with clouds. To create that, select the black background layer and go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise. Keep the amount 400%, set Gaussian and monochromatic, then click OK. Next, create a duplicate of this layer and hide the top layer. Select the second layer and apply Gaussian blur. Set the radius amount to 0.7 pixel. Then under Image, Adjustment, Levels, put the value 200 and click OK. This will add a small particles on the background. We'll use the first layer to add bigger particles. So select the first layer and set the Gaussian blur radius value to 2.2 pixels. Then under Levels, play around with the values. If we put lesser value on the left box, the particles are bigger. And as we increase the value, it decreases. So put 155 and 177, then click OK. Now with the selection tool, make a selection of the black area. Delete the layer and add a new layer. Now inverse the selection area using the shortcut Command or Control Shift and I. Then select white color and apply it. Use Command or Control D to remove the selection. Next, apply Gaussian blur of radius 1.8 pixel to the selected area. Add outer glow under layer style panel. Choose white color for the outer glow with a size 4 pixel. Now merge the last two layers. Apply Gaussian blur to soften the particles. Next, add a new layer and go to Filter, Render, Clouds. Then change the layer mode to Color Dodge. Now add a new layer between the particle background and the clouds. Select the brush tool, choose green color from the sphere using the eye picker tool, set the opacity to 10% and on the brush panel, make sure smoothing is selected. Now start applying the brush over the empty space. This will add a soft cloud in the background. Apply it properly in order to get a natural feel. Reduce the opacity of the cloud layer to match it with the background layer. Next, we'll type out the title text, Algae. Apply light green yellowish color with the font Tecton Pro Bold. Finally, we have completed designing the organic algae using Photoshop. During this process, we have used the layer style option in a very unique way and also used few new techniques. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.